Greetings, I'm Raymond Francis, and for those of you who have not seen one of these tapes before, they are based on my book, Never Be Sick Again. There is a model of health that is outlined in Never Be Sick Again that we call the Beyond Health Model. This model is simple so that anyone can put it to use in their life to prevent disease and to reverse disease. The model is based on there being only one disease, and that is a malfunctioning cell. Disease is really the result of cells that are not working right. We're all made of cells, and these little units of life that we started, actually each of us started life as one cell, a single cell in our mother, and now we're multi-trillion cells. But if all those cells are working the way they're supposed to work, you cannot be sick. The only way you can be sick is when a large number of those cells are malfunctioning. Well, as it turns out, they only malfunction for two reasons. One, they're not getting everything that they need to function properly, and we call this problem deficiency. Or they're getting something that's interfering with their metabolic machinery, and we call that problem toxicity. So there's merely one disease, a malfunctioning cell, and only two causes of disease, deficiency and toxicity. And then there are six pathways to disease. And the six pathways are the nutrition pathway, the toxin pathway, the mental or the psychological pathway, the physical pathway, the genetic pathway, and the medical pathway. So there are six pathways to disease. And today we're going to be talking about the nutrition pathway, but very specifically in the nutrition pathway we talk about something called the Big Four. The Big Four are the four foods that cause most of the disease in our society. And the Big Four are sugar and white flour and processed oils and dairy / excess animal protein. Today, we're going to be talking about dairy and excess animal protein. So, do you drink milk? Do you eat cheese? Yogurt? How much meat do you eat? How much is too much? How much is too little? Americans are a nation of milk drinkers and meat eaters. Is this healthy? Let's have a look at milk first. Milk is Mother Nature's perfect food. But the perfect food for what or for whom? It's the perfect food for the infant of a particular species. So cow's milk is the perfect food for a calf. Look at what happens in nature. Humans are the only species that drink the milk of another species. Humans are the only species that drink milk after weaning. Now, drinking milk as we do, drinking the milk of another species, drinking milk after weaning, is not normal. It does not exist in nature, with the exception of us. And as a result, what we're finding is that because drinking milk is not natural, it's not a good idea. You cannot cross-species feed, and you cannot drink milk after weaning. And Mother Nature jumps through hoops to protect us from doing this. The milk of each species is biochemically designed specifically for that species. It is unique to the specifications of that species. Cow's milk is designed to turn a 60-pound calf into a 600-pound cow in 1 year. Well, we don't need to become 600-pound cows, but many of us are. There is no human requirement for milk from a cow. None. Yet, many Americans drink 100 gallons of milk per year. Mother Nature does not want us to do this and tries its best to protect us from it. Most humans make lactase. This is an enzyme that digests the sugar in milk for only about 4 to 5 years. Most adults are intolerant to lactase. Only 25 to 30% of the world's population drinks any milk at all. And most people cannot drink milk because it will make them sick. They're lactose intolerant because Mother Nature wants them to be lactose intolerant so that they cannot drink milk, because drinking milk is a bad idea. Here's an interesting statistic. 4% of the world's population drinks more milk than the other 96% put together. Well, who do you think that 4% is? Guess who? It's your friends and neighbors and your family. It's the crazy Americans. The crazy Americans drink more milk than the rest of the world combined, because the rest of the world knows it's a bad idea. Dairy products make up to 1/3 of the adult diet in America. And this leads to insufficient intake of essential nutrients, because nutrients are lacking in the milk that we should be getting, and yet we're consuming the milk instead of the other foods, the vegetables that we should be eating. Cow's milk is different. First of all, 4 times the protein of human milk. So cow's milk is especially rich in protein. It has 4 times the protein that's in human milk, and this is very significant. Not only does it have 4 times as much protein, it has the wrong protein. And this is really, really significant. Cow's milk is very rich in a protein called casein. And casein is not something we ought to be eating, because human milk is very rich in a protein called whey. So we've reversed it when we drink cow's milk. We drink too much casein and not enough whey. And caseins are difficult for humans to digest. You see, cows have 4 stomachs. We only have 1. And they have different ways of dealing with the casein, but we don't. Hard to digest. So the casein, the undigested casein, goes down into the lower intestines where it putrefies. And it creates all kinds of toxins that are then absorbed into the body. And these undigested proteins can actually go through the gut, especially if you have what we call leaky gut syndrome. Go right through the gut and then become allergens in the body. And this is why so many of us are allergic to milk. Cow's milk has 5 to 7 times the mineral content of regular human milk. So very rich in protein, very rich in minerals, but guess what? Too many minerals. The minerals are in cow's milk because you've got to build all those really big bones and all those hoofs the proteins in there to build all those big muscles. We don't have that requirement. It has 6 to 10 times less essential fatty acids, so it's not designed for our unique specialization. Here you see the cow's milk has a lot of protein, has a lot of minerals to build all those big muscles, all those big bones, and it's very lacking in essential fatty acids. And what do we need them for? To build our brains. So human milk has rich in essential fatty acids because we build a big brain. And that's why we can do what we can do, why we think the way we do, and our mental capacity is so great, because we build these very wonderful brains out of those essential fatty acids. And that's why breastfed children, on average, have about 10 points higher IQ than bottle-fed children, because they get more of the essential fatty acids from the mother's milk. It's high in saturated fat. Cow's milk is high in saturated fat, and this increases our cholesterol levels. Cow hormones, you know, cow's milk is loaded with hormones, but these hormones are not intended for humans. They're intended for cows, and they're not intended for adults. They're intended for a calf. And cow's milk lacks specific glycoproteins, Well, these are chemicals that are in mother's milk. And in our mother's milk, these glycoproteins go down into the intestines and they coat the gut. And this protects the gut from infection. It sets up a protective barrier. When you're drinking cow's milk, you don't get these glycoproteins, you don't get the protection, and now you're more likely to get an infection in your gut. And indeed, this actually happens quite often. Commercial milk, you know, not only is cow's milk bad, but by the time you drink commercial milk, buy something at the supermarket, it's really often to Never Never Land, because it is a toxic chemical, biological, and bacterial soup that is unfit for human consumption. And let me say this over again. Cow's milk is unfit for human consumption, most especially that which you purchase at the supermarket, this highly processed product. These are diseased animals that this milk is coming from. So we're drinking an unhealthy fluid from diseased animals containing numerous disease-causing substances. And let me read off some of these substances to you. Antibiotics, hormones, herbicides, pesticides, dioxins, detergents, radioactive fallout, PCBs, bacteria, pus, viruses, feces, blood, and solvents. All in the milk you're purchasing at the supermarket and feeding to yourself and your children. By conservative estimate, there's about 100 antigens released by the digestion of normal cow's milk, creating a flood of antibodies that wreak havoc on our cells and tissues, and even killed viruses that can still generate antibodies. Dairy causes and has been associated with many diseases, including allergies and Alzheimer's and appendicitis and asthma and autism and cancer and Crohn's disease and diabetes, type 1 diabetes, terrible disease, ear infections, asthma. In fact, ear infections, it's the leading cause of ear infections. Eczema, enlarged tonsils, heart disease, iron deficiency anemia, juvenile delinquency, leukemia, Lou Gehrig's disease, lymphoma, multiple sclerosis, osteoporosis, salmonella infections, and streptococcal infections, all caused by drinking milk. Allergies. Let's look at allergies. One of the three most common allergens, undigested casein. In other words, that's that protein in the milk that you can't digest. That's one of the three top allergens. And most of the top allergens, by the way, are dairy and gluten, which you find in grains like wheat and rye and barley, eggs, corn, citrus, chocolate, and fish. Those are your top allergens. But dairy is right up there at the very top of the list. In fact, at this point, between 50 and 60% of our population is allergic to dairy, even though most of you don't know it. You're suffering the symptoms, but you accept the symptom as normal without realizing it's being caused by the dairy. And dairy is a leading cause of other allergies, because once you become allergic to the dairy, once you start reacting to the dairy, this makes you susceptible to other allergies. And so pretty soon, you've got a whole package of allergies, not just one. And some may even be allergic to the antibiotics. A lot of people are allergic to antibiotics, and of course, commercial milk is loaded with antibiotics. So a lot of people can have allergic reactions just to the antibiotics in the milk. You can get a wide range of symptoms by drinking milk, including abdominal pain and acne and asthma and bad breath, behavioral problems, bloating, cataracts, colic, constipation, depression, diarrhea, ear infections, fibroids, gas, headaches, hyperactivity. How many of our children are hyperactive today? Irritability, lack of energy, nasal congestion, nutrient malabsorption, poor appetite, sinus problems, and tonsil problems. How about Alzheimer's and heart disease? Well, dairy is rich in an amino acid called methionine. High methionine results in something called homocysteine, high homocysteine levels. And homocysteine, especially in the absence of adequate amounts of vitamin B6 and vitamin B12 and folic acid, will do a lot of damage to you. And we find a lot of people today are high in homocysteine. And people who are highest in homocysteine have the highest amount of Alzheimer's and the highest amount of heart disease. Autism, an attention deficit disorder. Milk protein breaks down into the body to a peptide called casimorphin. So here we have the casein that you're trying to digest, and we know it's difficult to digest. You're breaking it down, and one of the byproducts you're getting is something called casimorphin. And casimorphin is found in high concentrations in children with autism. And casimorphin is an opiate, and many people have been cured of autism simply by getting them off of dairy products. Cancer. We know that more than one glass of milk today increases your risk of ovarian cancer by 300%. Three glasses of milk per day increases the risk of lung cancer by 200%. And of prostate cancer by 250%. 40% of women and men over the ages of 40 and 50 already have prostate cancer and breast cancer in their bodies, just waiting to grow. So that's just amazing. 40% of men and women already have breast cancer and prostate cancer, just waiting to grow. And we know that milk causes these problems. There's something called insulin-like growth factor. This is in milk. It's a very powerful growth hormone that is included in milk, and it drives existing cancers. So if you have an existing cancer and you drink milk and you get insulin-like growth factor, this growth hormone is going to tell the cancer to grow. So milk will just feed cancer and make it grow. And the insulin-like growth factor that's in cow's milk is absolutely biologically identical to the insulin-like growth factor in humans. So it's going to have the same effect in humans. Only in humans, we control the amount in our blood. When we drink milk, we're increasing the amount in our blood artificially. So drinking milk can double the amount of growth hormone in you. And especially if you already have cancer, you don't want to do that. And even if you don't have cancer, you don't want to do that. Crohn's disease. You know, this is a chronic intestinal inflammation. It causes pain and bleeding and diarrhea. There's a mycobacteria that's in milk that releases compounds that inhibits the macrophages from killing pathogenic E. coli. So what does that mean? It means that this Crohn's disease, this irritation in the gut, is being caused by a bacterial infection and from E. coli. And there are germs, germ-like things, in the milk that release compounds that inhibit our immune system from protecting us from this infection. So again, when you're drinking milk, you're more likely to have Crohn's disease, you're more likely to drive Crohn's disease because you're inhibiting the body from protecting you against it. Diabetes, we know that milk causes type 1 diabetes. Cow's milk contains something called beta-lactoglobulin. Human milk does not contain this. And what this causes is the baby to make antibodies to this lactoglobulin. And these antibodies just happen to attack human tissue. These same antibodies will attack your tissue. And so here's something that causes the human immune system to become dysfunctional, because we're making antibodies to this beta-lactoglobulin that can actually attack our own tissue. And we call that, of course, an autoimmune disease. And that's what type 1 diabetes is. And Finland, by the way, Finland, the people in Finland actually drink more milk per capita than the people in the United States. I didn't know anybody was that crazy, but yes, the people in Finland are that crazy. They actually drink more milk than the average American does. And guess what? They have the highest rate of type 1 diabetes in the world. Ear infections, the leading cause of ear infections. At least 40% of all children up to age 6 get ear infections, and we know that drinking cow's milk is the leading cause of ear infections. Iron deficiency anemia. Cow's milk binds to the iron and protects, prevents the child from absorbing iron, and they end up with iron deficiency anemia. And also, because of allergic reactions in the gut to the cow's milk, it can actually cause bleeding in the gut and can cause a loss of iron from the child and cause anemia that way as well. Juvenile delinquency. There's a fatty acid deficiency that disables certain parts of the brain and causes people to do things they wouldn't ordinarily do. We know that the average juvenile delinquent drinks 4 to 10 times as much milk as the average child. And because they're doing this, they're not getting adequate amounts of essential fatty acids to build their brains, and their brains malfunction, and they become violent and antisocial. Leukemia. Bovine leukemia virus is found in 3 out of 4 dairy cows. And pasteurization, by the way, it is killed by pasteurization, but guess what? Even though it's killed by pasteurization, we're still seeing leukemia that is higher in the dairy-producing states. So it's still there, and we're passing this bovine leukemia virus to humans as a result of being exposed to this milk and drinking this milk. Lymphoma. Here's a cancer in the lymph system. In Norway, they did a study and they found that 2 glasses of milk a day increased your risk of developing lymphoma by 3.5 times. Osteoporosis. Milk interferes with calcium absorption, and milk's high protein causes calcium losses. So studies show that there is a worsening of calcium balance in the body with 3 glasses of milk a day. And countries with the highest milk consumption have the highest osteoporosis. Milk destroys your bones. Osteoporosis is virtually unknown outside of the dairy-consuming countries. Pasteurization. Now, here's something else we do to milk, and let's have a look at what pasteurization does. This is a heating process to reduce the number of bacteria in the milk, but it does not kill all the pathogens. It isn't designed to sterilize the milk. It's merely designed to reduce the number of bacteria in the milk. It often exceeds, milk often exceeds the legal limits for the number of bacteria. In fact, some studies have found that store-bought milk has so many bacteria they couldn't even count them. So some commercial milk bacteria counts are absolutely astronomical. And what happens is that sterilization, when you pasteurize the milk, you deactivate key enzymes in the milk. You deactivate enzymes. You actually change the entire physical and chemical state of the milk. And this reduces the biological bioavailability of the minerals in the milk. So it cuts calcium absorption in half, for example. simply by pasteurizing the milk, you destroy the ability to use minerals in the milk. And it denatures the proteins. In other words, it changes the structure of the proteins. Proteins are pretty delicate molecules, and when you subject them to heat, they can start changing, and that's what happens when you pasteurize the milk. And this impairs vitamin absorption from the gut. So these changed protein molecules will impair vitamin absorption. And what happens is that these molecules adhere to the gut tissue, and they prevent absorption because they're adhering to the gut tissue. And just as one example why you can't pasteurize milk, if you feed pasteurized milk to a calf, now remember, milk is meant for calves. If you pasteurize milk and feed it to a calf, all of the calves will be dead within 8 weeks. In fact, no calf has ever survived more than 8 weeks drinking pasteurized milk. So we feed it to our children. Then there's another thing we do to milk, and we call it homogenization. We homogenize the milk. And, you know, when I was a child, we'd buy milk and there'd be cream up at the top of the milk, and you'd have to shake the milk bottle to sort of disperse the cream. The cream would rise to the top. Well, that doesn't happen anymore because we break those little globules up into tiny, tiny little particles, and so the cream doesn't separate anymore. And this is the homogenization process, but the full effects of homogenization are simply unknown. It changes how the milk is metabolized. In other words, it changes how your body reacts to the milk. And it bypasses nature's plan. Nature's plan is you have those fat globules pretty large. We make them real small, so we bypass nature's plan. The smaller particles bypass the digestive process, and they can be absorbed directly into the body without being digested first. And that's not a good idea, because this analogy, the fat contains hormones, it contains chemicals, it contains all kinds of toxic chemicals that are in the milk. And now these little fat globules are getting directly into the bloodstream, carrying those hormones and those toxins directly into your blood. So this allows a flood of hormones and proteins directly into the blood system. This triggers allergies, it triggers autoimmune diseases. Milk contains an oxidizing enzyme called xanthine oxidase. Well, the xanthine oxidase usually globs in little globules that are too big to pass into the human body. But when you homogenize the milk, you break up those globules, and the xanthine oxidase gets into the bloodstream. And what happens is this then does oxidative damage to your arteries. And that's one reason why heart disease is associated with drinking milk, because this enzyme will do oxidative damage to your arteries. Now, milk is a poor source of calcium, and cow's milk is simply not a good source of calcium. Now, I know this is contrary to what we've all been told and what we all believe. Cow's milk contains 1,200 milligrams of calcium per quart. Human milk contains only 300 milligrams of calcium per quart. But guess where you get the most calcium? From human milk, not from the cow's milk. So cow's milk contains 4 times the calcium, but you get more calcium from human milk. The cow's milk is high in phosphorus, and the phosphorus reacts with the calcium, combines with the calcium in the cow's milk, and decreases its bioavailability to us. Now, cow's milk is also low in magnesium, and we need magnesium in order to metabolize calcium, and that's why human milk is much higher in magnesium. The cow's milk is too low in magnesium. Calcium is not properly metabolized. See, when you're putting all this calcium in, 4 times as much calcium, and it's not being properly metabolized, guess what? It ends up as kidney stones, it ends up as gout, ends up as bone spurs, hardening of the arteries, hardening of heart valves, calcifying soft tissue in your kidneys and your liver and wherever, not a very good idea. You got a lot of calcium running around the body, doesn't know what to do with, so it just stuffs it someplace, and that someplace may be your arteries, and you're getting hardening of the arteries. Another reason why drinking milk causes heart disease. Now, dairy protein, as we said before, is very, very different, and cow's milk is very high in protein. And this protein metabolizes to very strong acids. And our bodies use up calcium and magnesium to neutralize this acid. So where are you going to get that calcium and magnesium, folks? You're going to pull it out of your bones. So here you are pulling calcium and magnesium out of your bones to neutralize the acid that is being produced by metabolizing all that extra protein in the cow's milk. That's one reason why cow's milk causes osteoporosis. And cow's milk, of course, is more than 80% casein, and human milk is only 40% casein, and it's a different kind of casein. So we're not prepared to digest that casein from a cow. Toxins, antibiotics, 70% of all the antibiotics manufactured are fed to cattle. 70%. And guess what? Those antibiotics end up in the meat and in the dairy, and you're eating them on a regular basis. Treating mastitis. Mastitis is an infection that the cows get. Results from excess production of milk. See, we're producing too much milk from these poor cows and giving them hormones to stimulate the milk. And guess what? 50 years ago, the average cow produced 2,000 pounds of milk per year. That's 50 years ago, 2,000 pounds of milk. Cows today can produce up to 50,000 pounds of milk per year, and no wonder they're getting infections, and then we have to feed them a ton of antibiotics in order to keep them alive. Milk is okay to consume if you want to be sick. Most dairy cows are diseased. Most carry bovine leukemia and immunodeficiency viruses and bovine tuberculosis. In the name of good health, we are drinking contaminated body fluids from diseased animals. Does this make any sense? You have to figure it out for yourself. What about excess animal protein? Well, Americans eat, you know, we're talking about today the big four, and this is dairy / excess animal protein. What about excess animal protein? Well, Americans eat 10 times too much animal protein. And nearly all Americans eat 10 times too much animal protein. And people who consume the most animal protein suffer the most chronic disease. High animal protein diets are very acidic, and they make it difficult to retain calcium, and this produces osteoporosis. Animal protein in excess of the amount that you need to do daily repairs and daily growth promotes cancer. So diets that are low in animal protein inhibit cancer. Diets that have a lot of animal protein promote cancer. In fact, low animal protein diets will dramatically block cancer, whereas high animal protein diets will dramatically increase cancer, and most especially the worst protein of all is the casein in cow's milk. That's the worst protein of all. That makes cancer go off like a rocket ship. So even relatively small intakes of animal food can be associated with adverse effects. So be careful with how much animal protein you eat. I eat animal protein, but I limit the amount that I eat per day and per week. And anybody can do this. In summary, very few of us know what we should be doing to improve our health. Most of us give very little thought to what we eat. We eat what's convenient, we eat what our parents taught us to eat, and the amount of misinformation on diet is simply overwhelming. Science shows that a plant-based diet that is low in animal protein and devoid of milk products is the best diet of all. And that's the diet I suggest for all of you. And be sure to read my book, Never Be Sick Again, because it's filled with all kinds of additional information. Thank you for listening.